All right, we're going to do another coin problem. Beth has seven more quarters than dimes and one less nickel than dimes. Their total value is $3.70. How many of each type of coin does Beth have? All right, this time we're talking about three different types of coins, so we'll put this information in a chart, but we're going to have a column for three different kinds of coins instead of just one. So this is the kind of coin, the type of coin. And we'll always do a column for their unit value, in other words, how much it is for one coin. All right, so we have three types. So we're going to have three rows. And we've got quarters, dimes, and nickels. It doesn't matter what you write first, so I'll just put, quarters, dimes, nickels. So that's the type of coin. And then we know each quarter's worth 25 cents. I'm going to do everything in cents so that I don't have to use decimals. And then we need to have how many of each coin. Remember, you can put the word a little number sign if you want. It doesn't really matter how you fill that out. And then their value. Now, to get the value of the quarters, you've got to put 25 cents for each quarter. All right. Now we've got to figure out what our main variable, what we're going to use for our first variable, is that going to be the number of dimes, nickels, or quarters? So let's go back up to the original problem. Beth has seven more quarters than dimes. Well, I'd have to know how many dimes there were in order to figure out the number of quarters. So quarters can't be the first thing. One less nickel than dimes. All right, well, I have to know the dimes also to get the number of nickels. So the clue is I need to start out with a number of dimes. Let's let the number of dimes be x. Remember, you could use any letter you'd like. So if I've got x dimes, how many quarters would I have? She has seven more quarters than she has dimes. So the number of dimes is seven, I'm sorry, is x. She's got seven more, so that becomes x plus seven. All right, what about the nickels? How many nickels? She has one less nickel than dimes. Okay, so if she's got x dimes, one less, we're going to have to subtract one from how many dimes we have. Make sure you don't do 1 minus x. That will give you a negative number. All right, so how are we going to get the value? Remember, we take the unit value times how many we have equals the total value over here. So for the quarters, it's going to be 25 times x plus 7, right? 25 cents for each of those x plus 7 quarters. Number of dimes will be 10x, and the number of nickels will be 5 times x minus 1. And do I know the total value of all the coins? It says their total value is 370. Now it says $3.70 in money, I'm sorry, in cents, that means 370. So our equation will be to add these three to get 370. The value of the quarters plus the value of the dimes plus the value of the nickels is going to equal 370. So the equation will be 25 times x plus 7, that's the value of the quarters, plus how much all the dimes are worth, which is 10x, plus how much the nickels are worth, which is 5 times x minus 1, has got to equal 370. So that's the equation we need to solve. All right, so let's do it. You can put this on pause and work on your own first. So we have 25x, I'm going to do the distributive property, plus 175 plus 10x. Distributive property again gives you 5x minus 5 equals 370. Now I need to add the like terms on the left. So I have 25x plus 10x plus 5x. That's going to give you 40x. And I've also got the 175 minus 5. That's plus 170. All right, so I've simplified the left-hand side. Now we can subtract 170 from both sides to get the variables on one side and constants on the other. And finally, divide both sides by 40 to solve for x, 5. Now, what did x stand for? X stood for the how many? The number of dimes. So now we're going to go over here on the side and notice if x was, can you see it? X was 5, right? So I should have 5 dimes, right? 5 dimes. All right, what else? I've got one less nickel than dimes, so I must have 4 nickels, right? And what else do I have? I got 7 more quarters than dimes. So if I had 5 dimes, I've got 12 quarters. So it looks like this is going to be the answer right here. But of course, we want to check to make sure that would be worth $3.70. Remember, it should add up to $3.70. So let's see. Okay, so the question is that worth $3.70? All right, so 5 dimes would be 5 times 10 cents or 50 cents for the dimes. I've got 4 nickels. Each nickel's worth 5 cents, so that would be 20 cents. And I have 12 quarters, so that's 12 times 25, which is $3. And we just add it all up, and I get 370. So, yeah, that checks out, doesn't it? So the answer is she has 5 dimes, 4 nickels, and 12 quarters. And you could write that in a sentence as well. Was it a she or a he? Beth. Here we go. So we could say Beth has 5 dimes, 4 nickels, and 12 quarters. Good idea to go back, just write the original problem down on your own piece of paper and try it all on your own from start to finish, see how you do. And if you get stuck, then watch the whole video again. It's okay to do the same problem that I did to see if you understand how to do it.